Hi everyone, I'm Fang Xunzhong and I'm a PhD candidate at T-Stone Robotics Institute, the Chinese University of Hong Kong in Hong Kong, China. In this video, we introduce a new hand-eye calibration algorithm for robotic surgical instrument using the concept of interactive manipulation. This work has been published on the peer-reviewed journal IEEE Robotics and Automation Letters. Surgical robots have been widely introduced to clinical applications. The current paradigm of robotic surgery includes teleoperated robotic system, like the Da Vinci surgical system that allows the surgeons to perform surgical procedures remotely, and includes side-by-side robotic assistance, also under the surgeon's control. On the other hand, surgery autonomy has become a greater interest in robotic surgery, aiming to further relieve tedious tasks from the surgeon and to standardize the task operation. Although clinical use is yet not available, there have been studies that achieve autonomous needle control and knot tying in suturing, autonomous palpation, and robotic debridement. Surgical robots are mainly applied to minimally invasive surgery. The robotic instruments are designed as a cylindrical and a wristed structure whose motion is constrained by the remote center of motion, or the RCM. The surgeon relies on an endoscopic camera during the surgery. This requires long-term training from novice surgeons. If we let the robot to automatically perform these procedures, how to robustly localize a robotic surgical instrument subject to the preoperative setup for precise task execution becomes a crucial problem. Surgical instrument localization has been extensively studied via the tracking by detection scheme. Researchers have been using learning-based methods for concurrence detection and tracking the instrument in 2D images. By using external patterns, model-based approaches could lead to 3D instrument localization, but subject to the online sensing reliability problem. More recently, optimization-based approaches have been proposed to estimate the instrument's pose relying on salient features from the instrument. However, due to high-dimensional optimization, it imposes difficulty in real-time implementation. Another surgical localization scheme is hand-eye calibration. By obtaining the homogeneous transformation matrix capital T between the camera and the robot base, the instrument localization could be done without using the online sensory feedback after the calibration. The popular TIES method has been materially used for industrial robot arm, from which a checkerboard is mounted on the robot end effector to review the pose information upon the multiple group of data collection. To calibrate a surgical instrument, existing approaches also rely on a checkerboard or the CAD model of the instrument for completing the process. In this work, we present a new hand-eye calibration method for robotic surgical instruments. We propose the interactive feature plane, or the IFP, that helps us to review higher dimensional pose information of the instrument, which is determined by an adaptive controller for data collection and recovery. Our algorithm has several advantages compared to the existing methods. It is fully automated, it only requires 3 degrees of freedom of instrument motions, and it does not depend on any external calibration objects or large-scale data collection. The interactive manipulation aims to provide deliberate robot motions upon sensors monitoring to review higher dimensional sensory information. First, we choose a predefined robot trajectory parametrized by phi, which is periodical, passes a given robot configuration, and stays within a 3D plane pi, whose spatial property is further adjustable by a scalar theta. One simple example of such phi is the pendulum-like trajectory that sweeps the instrument shaft. As such motion could be implemented by only 2 degrees of freedom of RCM motions, the robot end effector position is computed using the forward kinematics as follows. By using the robot Jacobian, we could also obtain the velocity mapping between the joint space velocities of the robot and the feature space that characterize the IFP. Meanwhile, such motions will lead to the projected center line of the instrument to deviate from its original one on the image, whose velocity mapping to the joint space velocities is also computable even with an unknown instrument depth. Then, we can obtain the differential relationship between the feature space parameters of the IFP and its resultant center line deviation, d dot. With this velocity mapping, our aim is to minimize the center line deviation, d, by adjusting the theta to some theta sub d. As there is unknown depth information in this mapping, we use an adaptive controller to online update the parameters and also contribute to a convergence of d by using the following controller input to the surgical robot. The stability proof of this controller could be referred to our paper. Once the converged theta sub d is obtained, the normal vector of the resultant IFP could be described by both the camera frame and the robot base frame using the following calculation. If we repeat such process to get multiple novel vectors of multiple IFPs, we could get the matrix B and C containing data needing for the calibration. The problem is now equivalent to that, given a group of 3D vectors described in two 3D Cartesian coordinate frames, determine the full transformation matrix between these two frames. An existing mathematical solver could be found to solve the rotation matrix capital R between these two frames. Once the rotation matrix is computed, recovery of the position vector T could be done by initiating two robot configurations with only change in the insertion degree of freedom, or Q sub 3. By also recording the corresponding change of the instrument tip in 2D image, the position vector T is also computable via adapted estimation from our previous work. Up to now, both the capital R and T are computed, which means the calibration process is completed. We first conduct simulation on the VRAP platform using the DVRK model to show the convergence process of the IFP. By assuming the initial projected center line on the image as the target one, our adaptive controller adjusts the orientation of the IFP via theta until it is converged to the target center line in red. Note that after convergence, the instrument motion continues, but the center line projection remains unchanged on the image. Next, we used both the patient-side manipulator 1 and 2 to perform hand-eye calibration in our simulation. By collecting only two IFPs, the best calibration results could reach 2.2 mm in position error and 0.013 radian in rotation error. Comparative study is also conducted to evaluate the calibration performance in simulation by changing the camera's viewing angle, the sensing noise of the center line, and the instrument's distance from the camera. The accuracy does not significantly change due to the above setup. We used the Da Vinci Research Kit to conduct the experiment using a calibrated monocular camera as the input. To online detect the instrument, we first used deliberate motions from the instrument to generate static background image. Then, the instrument region of interest could be done by using the background subtraction algorithm, whose center line could be further determined. The experiment was run on a PC with 16GB RAM and an i7 processor without using GPU acceleration. The detection and control loop during calibration is 16 to 20 Hz. The rest skeleton indicates the back projected kinematics on the image using Tai's method, while the blue one indicates the result using our method. As the ground truth of the matrix, capital T, is not available, we use the back projected error of the instrument tip from the detected one to evaluate the accuracy. It could be seen that our method could lead to more accurate positioning of the instrument tip. The calibration process is done by collecting two IFPs, with the total time cost at about 10 seconds. We finally show a case study experiment which uses the calibrated instrument using our method to grasp a needle at a predefined 3D precision from the camera to show the calibration accuracy. After the calibration, the instrument is able to grasp the needle adjacent to its initial configuration with a manually measured 3D precision error of around 3.2 mm. By using the Tai's method, the grasping procedure fails due to the large precision deviation. To summarize, our hand-eye calibration method owns greater generality for clinical application with less offline information. The accuracy is good enough to grasp a surgical needle for task autonomy. In the future, we will also integrate this algorithm to autonomous execution of surgical tasks. Thank you very much for your listening.